Hello there, people. I have gotten yelled and screamed at because Microsoft is putting ads in the start menu. So I looked into it. And if we go on to the good old information page about, well, where you get the information about these things. I can't speak. Update celebrity and stuff like that. March preview, OS build, blah, 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 blah. Microsoft 11, Windows 11 versions. 22S2 old editions. They're talking about here that they're getting you new, well, ads, as people are calling it. And yes, I say as people are calling it, because if we look at it, this is what people have an issue with. I don't know, can I open this in a new tab? Back up your files, folders like documents, pics, blah, 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 blah. So what this is a OneDrive advertisement. I will kind of, yeah, it is kind of an advertisement or suggestions. And if you look in here at NeoVenus, I think these are the guys, or this site was the one that comes out with it the first. It's all the way from March. People talk about it in April. They also talk about that you can turn it off, apparently. Show account-related notifications occasionally in start. And you can go in here and you can do some voodoo-voodoo. So apparently you can turn it off. So even if this is an issue, you can turn it off. But when I hear people bitch and moan about this, I was thinking, okay, I'm going to get ads from Pornhub. I'm going to get ads about, you know, the latest skimp suit discounts. I'm going to get apps from Amazon. I'm going to get apps from Netflix to resubscribe to them and stuff like that. Or getting apps to buy a new HP laptop and so on. That's what I hear. But if you look at it in here and you look at this article here, it's Windows use or Microsoft using Windows to promote Microsoft technologies. Have you seen this in any other operating system? Yes, macOS do it, Linux do it. We have Canonical promoting the Canonical One back in the day, I think it was. We have almost any Linux distribution recommending that you are logging on online to online accounts or have at least an option for it in doing the setup menu if you're using GNOME. We have Linux distribution pre-installing Thunderbird, Firefox, LibreOffice, all shit I don't need, I don't want, I delete. Yes, you can use Arch and so on. We could even go in and say that Canonical pre-installing Snap packages, which a lot of you guys are angry about, is a promotion of Canonical technologies. Again, we could talk about Fedora pre-installing, pre-using flat packages that is promoting our open source Linux technology. You're just not getting a notification about it. This is not what I thought it was, because I have looked into this before and I was like, yeah, it's irritating, but I will not regard this an ad. When I think ads, you know, ads, I think about advertisement from third-party vendors. I'm thinking about, like I said, this is your local swinger club. We have an open house. Bring your own fucking drinks tonight at 8. You know, that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking about ads. This is an ad. You know, that's an ad. This is an ad. When people are yelling at me for Microsoft doing this, I was like, oh my God, am I going to get, you know, ads like this in my start menu? And in reality, it's just Microsoft saying that we have this technology. You kind of nowadays, which I don't agree with this, but Microsoft is pushing like having and you have to register a Microsoft account to use Windows. I think that's bullshit, but let's be honest here. It's the future. You need an account to fucking take a shit nowadays. Let's be honest here. And what they are saying is that with this account, you get a OneDrive that you can use as a backup. It's no different from, let's say, Mint. When you go into your Mint update tool, they are like, hey, remember to set up a backup scheme like time shift and stuff like that. That's basically what they are doing. They are telling you, why not utilize this thing? If you are not logged in, if you're running a local account up here, you will get like not signed in kind of warning. That must also be an ad then. So the bare minimum here is that if you look into this, it's not fucking that big of a deal. And if you can turn it off, as they say you can, and I hope you can, I don't know this, it's still not that big of a fucking deal. It's Microsoft telling you that, hey, remember, you have this drive thing you can use as a backup, to back up your pictures and stuff like that. And you know what? A lot of people fucking need that. just like when you're opening up the Mint Software Center, it's say, or Update Center, it's saying, you know what? Why not set up time shift? I think even under the introduction menu, Mint tells you to back ups via time shift and whatnot. Is this not advertisement for Firefox? Is this not advertisement for Rhythmbox and Spotify? I'm just asking. What about this here? Curium MPV, VLC. This is the installer recommending us things to do, things to use. Inkscape game drawing, Pixel, Skype, WhatsApp, Slack, Telegram. So Microsoft want you to, or remind you that you have this cloud storage available. They are telling you or recommending you to use Spotify. That's the editor's pick. Snapshots. Let's set up. What if I don't want snapshots? This is a little bit of an advertisement recommendation. Update menu here. Into the update menu, this tool provides security update, system snapshots. Okay. So we got like, they were talking about snapshots in there also. How is that different than reminding you that you have a storage device online that you can store shit on? Personally, this is my personal opinion. This should not do it, or they could go at it in another way. I don't see this as a big problem. I see it as a problem, but not a big problem. There is a lot of other things Windows do that, like, I think is bad, okay? There's a lot of things with Windows I hate more than this. Like, plenty of other shit. Again, I thought I would be getting this in my start menu. What I am getting is Microsoft reminding you that you have this thing you're not using, do you want to use it? This is way out of proportions from the way that I got told it from the good old Linux people. Like, this is way crazy. Is it irritating? Should they do it? Kinda no. They can, like I said, go about it in different ways. But it's way different from the way they are telling it. They are talking like I said, that you're getting IBM advertisement, Lenovo advertisement, Amazon advertisement, Google ads in there, and all of these crazy shit that we have to deal with all the time. All it's doing is reminding you to set up a backup. I think what this is the Linux community having so little to bitch and moan about right now that they're going after this. They're going after, this is all they have a bits and moan about, apparently. This is the biggest issue for Linux people and some Windows people, this here. If this is all you have to bits and moan about, you're fucking having a good time. Let's be honest. Or put it in this way, if you want to bits and moan about this versus all the other shit that Microsoft is doing, either you are blind like a bat, or you really don't have anything to bitch and moan about Microsoft for. This here is the least of your issues, especially if you can toggle it off. Maybe we need to calm our fucking fake anger. We are not the news here, okay? We are YouTubers. We don't fearmonger people. We don't spread out sensational bullshit to get people afraid and angry to do what we want them to do. Because that's what it sounds like Linux users are doing. They're trying to scare an angry Windows users to use Linux. Not how you go about it. Okay? Not how you go about it. See you all later. Bye-bye.